So, this is the internet, right? Hello, Vortex. Hello. I'm not sucked in by you, though. Not now, because I'm using a camcorder to film this. So I don't have constant access to the internet. Because I don't believe in that. I really don't even believe in this phone either. I don't like it. But my parents want to communicate with me. I'd rather just randomly show up at the retirement home and see them. They insisted that they go to a retirement home. They're not old enough to qualify, but they went anyway. It's more of a security thing. And I'll be honest with you. As much as I'd love to claim that I could take care of them, I could barely take care of myself some of the time. My mother fell, and my dad couldn't get her up because she's really overweight. And so they had to call the authorities to come get her. Now, a lot of times when old people fall, that's why Life Alert exists, apparently. When old people fall, they can't get up. So my dad, being the ever so reliable control freak that he is, wasn't okay with this. So he and my mother sold their house and they moved into this retirement community. It's right up the street from where I work. And they got rid of their house phone. I literally started crying when my mother told me that. Mainly because they've had the same number for like 20 years, right? And it's still in my phone. That number is still in my phone and it says home. And it makes me very sad. Most people that have a smartphone, they don't even know what their own phone number is. That's not good, y'all. That's not good. The sole purpose of having the phone was to communicate. And if you don't even know your own phone number, that other people will call in order to communicate with you, then obviously we've missed the mark. That's Greek for sin. Now, contrary to however reprehensible I seem to be in regards to my judgment, my righteous judgment of society, I feel like it's righteous because I'm right. However mean I seem to be, because I hate what society does to itself to voluntarily commit suicide, though they want to pretend that it's everybody else doing that. I promise that I mean well. And I hope to inspire people to be better. And I feel like all the stuff that we have, not just the phones, but like literally everything is designed to just rob us of our ability to solve problems. Rob us of our ability to, like, understand ourselves. These motherfuckers look to psychiatrists for answers, okay? And then you wonder why school shootings happen. People don't know how to deal with anybody that's struggling. They don't know how to deal with anybody that is in any kind of mental or emotional trouble. They just throw that person away. And then whenever that person gets thrown away and they're bitter about it, they get mad because of that bitterness. And then they call that person a monster. I'm not trying to justify anybody's actions, but what I'm saying is that, like, the way that they solve problems is wrong. So, they can't expect a positive outcome when this is the way that they deal with things that they don't understand. So, you know, psychiatrists, psychologists, therapists, the left, they have a field day with this shit. And then people on the board are like, they're possessed! They're so possessed! Oh, hey, that's my pickle bucket that I forgot. I'm growing food at my house. My friend Peter is helping me. You guys, I just saw a little bumper sticker on a car and said, "This machine kills fascists." How original. Are they talking about the car? Are they talking about the smartphone that they have on their car? No doubt. No doubt. No motherfucking doubt. You guys, I brushed my hair. You should have seen it. It was like so poofy. It was really curly though. I wanted to leave it, but it was like half of it looked really cool and the other half just looked like five birds slept in it. But I was originally gonna talk about the internet, right? Arlo is always with me. That's my recently deceased cat. That's why he died, because he ate my clothes on a regular basis. Which was partially my fault because I left them out and I didn't realize that he was so self-destructive. My manager's gonna fucking kill me. That's because you're looking at him and smiling. That's how it works, Amy. That's how it works. The law of attraction. A little bit too now. I'm like super duper excited.